Thanks for coming to Ponderland. On Ponderland tonight, I'm pondering childhood, right? And yeah, childhood, unusual, because as a child, you sort of take things on face value, right? And have an odd way of prioritising things. In my childhood, these are the things I thought about most. One, rabies and getting rabies. I was really worried about it. And as a result, I know a lot about rabies even now. What are you scared of water? Have you got a foam around your mouth? Rabies, mate. And also, quicksand. I was really worried about quicksand. Oh no! There might be quicksand! Careful of quicksand! Quicksand is only in the Beano. It ain't everywhere, is it? And I was worried about it on a daily basis. Oh God, there could be some quicksand. If quicksand is so dangerous, how come that sign that's stuck in the quicksand was just quicksand? How come that don't stink? It ain't dangerous then, is it? And you know, what about when you're at school, them children that's been brought up by their nan kids, I call them, right? They've not been brought up by their mum and dad. They're sort of a bit different to us, ain't they? Oh, bloody hell, nan countdown's on in a minute. Better get the working out paper. Right, look at this. Here is a picture of a nan kid. Look at him. What a little square, helping, doing cakes and that. Oh, hello, nan, I've made another trifle. Shall we put a drop of sherry in it? Rude not to, eh, nan? What a little boffin. Right, my childhood, though, it weren't that sort of vibe. My childhood were much more this kind of mood. Not particularly this context, but look at the mood here and also watch all the characters in this little drama because there's a lot of templates of childhood activity being played out. We can learn a lot from this.
Are you trying
something?
Take it easy.
Kid, I'm the kid walking away. That's what I was like in my childhood. My whole childhood was that mood. Why has that just happened? One of the kids, as crying boxing glove kid walks past, he is so happy that he's not the one that's been hit that he does a sort of little body pop jig of delight. Watch out for that now.
I never hit him hard, did I?
Yeah. So, right, what about this when you're a child? Why is it that that your dad has got a dead brown willy, but your willy is much more pink? Why is that? Because my willy were the colour of a prawn, and it resembled prawns in other areas. Like dimension! Right? But my dad's willy were really brown. My dad's willy looked like an independent wild animal. But when you get a glimpse of my dad willy, like that, and like it looked like it rambled out of a woodland. Oh my word, what's that? Will I get one of those? My one's still not gone that brown. I'm still like, you know, it ain't that brown yet. And also, this is the thing I thought about a lot in my childhood and still think about it a lot now. The advert for Cocoa Pops, think about it all the time. I'd rather have a bowl of Cocoa Pops. That's in my head all the time. If I'm not thinking about something else, I think about that. That is the screensaver for my mind. I'd rather have a bowl of Cocoa Pops. It just comes in there. The advert's obviously really been successful. I'd rather have a bowl of Cocoa Pops. It's just in there all the time. Right, as a child, you can make a game out of anything, dead simple things you could have a laugh with. Don't have to be anything complicated. Listen to like the way this like old fella, when he were a lad, look at how he entertained himself. Every element of his entertainment is vaguely depressing and a bit sort of grimy. Listen.
We found this old tin bungalow bath on the tip and we used to jump in this bath and sail down this ditch. Believe me, there'd be hundreds of rats. And we'd probably stop there for 2 or 3 hours till 8, 9 o'clock at night, killing rats.
It's killing rats. We used to sail down a ditch with a stick, killing rats. Like everything in it's a bit grim, isn't it? I'd be too frightened to go and sail down a ditch in a tin bath, knowing that at the end of it was just killing rats as a game, right? But fear is used an awful lot in childhood to control people. I remember being told, oh, be careful with chewing gum. Don't ever swallow chewing gum, dear, or it'll make a web inside you, run across you, it'll be. And, oh, don't eat the pips in an apple. It'll make a tree grow. The tree will bloom through bungalow you're in. You'll be like a tree, boy. You will know what a love you're in. Right, and then I remember, right, I used public information films. I remember the use of public information films to give us information, but... Right, some public information films, okay, that's good, I'm a member of the public, thanks for the information. But look at this one, its target is much too specific to warrant the making of a whole film to be shown on a mainstream medium like TV. Look at this public information film, it's too specific.
A grain pit looks like a sandpit to a child. It looks like somewhere nice to play, but it's not. It's like quicksand, or it's a way to drown without water. It will suck a child down before you can save it. So keep the children away and put a grid on it.
That's too specific, right? That's an advert for people that own grain pits. Unless you're one of the 58 million people who don't have a grain pit, just stay focused. It would be much more cost-effective, right, just to go to the three people in England who have got grain pits, phone them up in one morning, or individually go around their house with a solid gold grid and deliver it in a Rolls Royce. It costs much less money, aimed at about three people. Might as well have advert at... Do you have a Concorde? Where are the keys to your Concorde? Have you put them somewhere safe? Don't leave them where a child could get them. A child could get into that Concorde. We know Concorde are dangerous. We remember that crash. Imagine a tiny child in a Concorde. Could do anything. Could raise a lot of menace. Are you Diana Ross? Yeah. Don't leave your curling tongs where a child could get them. They could style their hair in an irresponsible way. But that's an unnecessary advert. Plus, right, listen to this advert. This is meant to as well. If you want kids not to swim in water, right, just get John Craven, get him to turn up and tell him, go, all right, kids, don't swim in water, it's dangerous. Don't make a Bergman-esque parable about the dangers of it, all full of sexual undertones and terrifying metaphor. It's mind-bending. Look at this.
I am the spirit of dark and lonely water, ready to trap the unwary, the show-off, the fool. And this is the kind of place you'd expect to find me. This branch is weak, rotten. It'll never take his way. Only a fool would ignore this. It's the perfect place for an accident.
Oi, look, there's someone in the water. Quick, you step these things and get him out.
Sensible children, I'll be back.
Brightening! Scared of water, I'm scared of that advert. After you've watched that advert, I think, bloody hell, that advert's terrifying. Mum, I've seen something awful on the television. I'm going over the swamp for a swim to unwind. A lot of pressure. This programme here, Boy from Space, I remember this. This is dark, deep, deep, dark within my unconscious mind, this bit of educational film. Right, this clip here is designed to teach children how to spell the words Mac and Hat. Children under six, how to spell the words Mac and Hat. What's the best way to do that? Oh, yeah, like this. This is the best way, I reckon.
He came towards us. He was tall and thin, and he had a Mac and a hat on. He looked very pale and strange.
Spell Mac and Hat. Oh God, what's going on? Terrifying. It's like showing a video of your parents being murdered, and then going, okay, have a look at that. There's a video of your parents being murdered. Now, can you spell gag, rope, and growing up alone? I feel so sad. Spell it. Spell gag. Dad, you worried about mummy. So should we, do you think, let children live in a glorious kind of, it's Lollipop Lane, it rains lemonade, what a wonderful world? Or should we let them know the truth that life is sometimes difficult? This American folk singer, right, he called Peter Allsop, he thinks, just be honest to children about difficult subjects, honestly, like AIDS and death.